Welcome to this service of Tenebrae on Maundy Thursday evening. I invite you to join with me in finding somewhere quiet to sit, and if it's safe and you're able to do so, to have in front of you 9 lit tea lights or candles. The pattern of this service will be that we will extinguish a candle and then we will hear a Bible reading taken from the time when Jesus is in the Garden of Gethsemane with his friends. After we've heard the reading, there will be a taizé chant that we can listen to or join in with, and a moment to pause. We will then put out the next candle, and so on. When we have heard the 8th reading, we will then put out the 9th candle and pause, and then relight all of the candles. And I invite you to stay where you are in silent reflection for as long as you feel able. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me." And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after another, "Surely not I, Lord." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." He replied, "You have said so."
Thank you.
Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples. After Jesus had spoken these words, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence, with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word.
Oh,
I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, so that they also may be sanctified in truth. I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me, and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one.
Oh,
He came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down and prayed. "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done." Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground.
Thank you.
they went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be distressed and agitated. And he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray, that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough, the hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners."
Thank you.
Immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. And with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." So when he came, he went up to him at once and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak. And after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him. "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.